welcome in to TalkFCB, and welcome back here to career mode. It is time again to head back into the world of Barcelona, but from a much better point of view. Welcome here to FIFA 20. It's all going down. We've enjoyed ourselves so far, but the big test to come. And in today's video, we're going to try out a new system. We've got lots of goals coming up, and certainly, RIQUI PUIG has a masterclass. Let's do it. So in episode 3, this is basically what we were talking about trying out in today's episode. It was a new formation, it was a new structure in the team. We were putting Messi back out onto the right-hand side, and that was basically to allow Lautaro and Griezmann to start together as they did, and it worked so well that I thought I would try this, and I would do it in one game. I'm not going to make it a regular feature. What I want to do is just see how it goes, a little experimentation, and that's going to be coming up there in our first game of today's episode, coming against Villarreal at the Camp Nou, before we then, just a few days later, head to Getafe. But let's first of all remind you of how things stand right now in La Liga. The table as follows: Atletico top of the league there, but they have played a game more than Real and Barca. We are perfect so far. 5 games, 5 wins, but we're always looking for improvements. We're looking for that added edge. We're really going to need it. And let's now head to the press conference where the media are waiting. Let's now see what questions they have for me today. Always in good mood, the media. It's not been the greatest start to the season so far. Challenge of the title looks to be a difficult ask now. Do you have the quality to get back on track? What, because Atletico have played one more game than us and they're just 3 points ahead? Listen, I will walk out of this conference. I will not stand for these kind of questions. We are ready and we can win this title. Barcelona are currently on a winning streak. That's more like it. They've won their last 5 games. Will you keep it going against Villarreal? The streak will continue. Don't worry, guys. Don't panic. We are going to continue the winning run and we will get to the top of that league, whatever it takes. Barca won the last match with a comfortable margin of 2 goals. Do you reckon that Villarreal's morale is dwindling because of that? We get this question a lot. No, I'm going to say there. The lads played very well. Let's get on now with the game itself. And so here we go then with that new formation, the new structure. Messi on the right, Dembele on the left, and Lautaro and Griezmann leading the line. And it is going to be a very interesting experiment here at the Camp Nou against Villarreal. We would expect to win the game. It's not going to be an easy game, but we are going to have to see here how it works. Can we get Messi involved enough on that right-hand side? Can Lautaro and Griezmann continue to link up there in that midfield area? But now we arrive at the Camp Nou, or what is apparently the Camp Nou. It is time to start the game. Villarreal against Barcelona. We need to continue that winning streak. We have to keep winning games because Real and Atletico, they're not letting up. They can't stop winning. And as a result of that, neither can we. And here we go then, ready for kickoff now. Lautaro will get us underway there, passing it back to Arthur Melo as we now kick off. And let's see how this goes here into Frenkie de Jong in that midfield area alongside Arthur. Those two have been so, so good for me right throughout the season so far. Semedo as well on this right-hand side has been in good form. Nice little turn there by Frenkie de Jong into Arthur. Evades the tackle nicely. Nice little ball there by Frenkie into Griezmann, but I can't quite get the return pass there to Luis Suarez early on. Piqué now starting out from the back into Frenkie. Griezmann, as you can see there, a little bit deeper in his role, getting a little bit more involved, as he can do. He can be a very creative player when he wants to be here. Back and forth to the midfield. Frenkie heavily involved, as he always is. Back here to the right-hand side. Messi getting a little bit of space. Good run there from Suarez. Opens it up for Messi, who sticks one in. That's exactly the kind of impact we wanted there. Messi picking the ball up on the right-hand side, making that inside run. Suarez then curves his own run, opens up all of that space for Lionel Messi, and that's all you need. A yard or two of room there. Messi on his left side. What a finish that is. Barcelona have the lead nice and early here against Villarreal. And that is there, guys, the absolutely perfect start to this game for us with a new system, with Messi there out on the right-hand side. You want him to have that kind of impact. A brilliant, brilliant goal. We've got to watch out, though. Villarreal now are on the attack. Longley coming across to cover against Samuel Chukwueze. Ball in here from Villarreal. Ter Stegen opts to punch that one into the path there of Griezmann. Now Lautaro, bit of a break on here for Barcelona. Messi coming central, playing it in to Lautaro Martinez. Griezmann as well. He's up in support. Kind of square it across. Probably could have gone for goal, but I just thought Griezmann there was in a good position, Couldn't quite get it to work. Here come Villarreal now, though, on the attack again. We have to be cautious. They do have good players here. Santi Cazorla into Ontiveros. Now Moreno. Dangerous area here. The Villarreal Ontiveros. Brilliant save from Ter Stegen. Pique came across. Couldn't quite get there, but a really good stop. De Jong now into Griezmann again, coming nice and deep to collect that one. Messi looking for Semedo on the overlap. That's where he needs to be here. Exploding into space. Griezmann back to Semedo. Lays it back. Lionel Messi. Oh, I thought it was in. Off the post there. Wonderful move that was. Semedo then. Griezmann involved as well. Messi making that central run. Hits it on the run. So close. At halftime, it's Barca 1, Villarreal 0. Things are going pretty well. But I have to be completely honest with you guys. I'm not entirely sure with Messi out on the right-hand side whether we're getting the absolute best out of him. What I'm going to do there is put Messi back in the middle. I'm going to take Griezmann off, give him a bit of rest there, head of that game against Getafe. Fati's back in the team with Dembele there on the right-hand side. That's the way that we are going to kick off in the second half. Hopefully, we can continue what we started. Villarreal now, 20 minutes or so on the clock to come. Only one goal in. Again, we want to score more goals. That's absolutely clear. Here goes Messi, though, onto Lautaro Martinez now. Moving into space is his man Dembele. He's got Ansu Fati with him. And that is an easy goal. And I believe the very first goal there of Ansu Fati in the colours of Barcelona. I could have taken it on there with Dembele, but at 1-0, you've got to be sure. It's not a nice thing to do. It's not made it the most pretty goal ever, but we've made sure of the points here. Dembele into Ansu. No doubt about the finish. And it's really good play. Messi starting it off. Lautaro involved. It's not just about goals. He's got to create as well. He did that there. And I'm so happy that Ansu is off the mark. And I think the game as a whole has been quite a difficult one here against Villarreal. They have posed a threat, certainly going in the other direction. Barcelona going forward have been quite good in front of goal. A little bit more efficient today, I feel, but it hasn't certainly been the easiest game here at the Camp Nou. Longley trying to get a tackle in here. Here's Bellarabi, Lamela, two new signings there for Villarreal, but Frenkie de Jong so good in those kind of areas. And Barcelona here are on the break once again. Ousmane Dembele looking out to the right. No pass on there. Lautaro again getting involved. Dembele out to Messi. Dembele looking again. He couldn't quite get onto that. Messi there playing into the area. So close there. Hoping to get a goal it was for Dembele. Move here into the final moments of the game. The points seem secure for Barcelona. And there is the final whistle. It's a 2-0 win. It wasn't incredible. It was a bit of an experiment for most of that match there. I think we've learned a lot. And the most important thing, we have our 3 points. We go on now to the next one. And to be honest, guys, after that experiment there, we've looked at 4-2-3-1 as well this season. What I'm going to do here is go back to the standard 4-3-3, but actually with a bit more of an attacking spin on it. You've got Fati there, Dembele, nice and wide, but also nice and high up the field as well, so they can get involved in those attacking areas. You've got Messi there, just behind Griezmann, and De Jong and Arthur have enough quality about them to marshal that midfield area. And I think that could be a system there that certainly works, that really functions for Barcelona, and in this career mode, that's what I'm going to continue with as of right now. And if we just take a look here at the schedule that we have currently, we are going to play Getafe in just a moment. We got a big month coming up in October. Some absolutely massive games going to be coming in the month of October there. Inter, Sevilla, you've got Eibar, Slavia Prague, and then later on in the month, building up already to El Clasico. And this here is how the table currently looks. Once again, Atletico, Real and Barca all remain perfect with 6 out of 6 wins. Sevilla are all that far back as well with just one win less. In this game, same as always, we've got to win. But as you saw with our previous Champions League game, guys, I make no mistake about it, always rotate before the Champions League. Simple as that here. We got Pedri, we got Fati playing, we got RIQUI PUIG in midfield. First appearance there for Sergio Busquets as well. Junior Firpo comes in, Todibo as well, and Moussa Wage there at right back. And I'm really excited about this. Getafe away is a tough game, but these young players, they've got quality, they've got talent, and we, in this game again, hopefully, we'll get to see that. And I think certainly this game right here will be very much a learning process, just like the last one. Not maybe in terms of the experimentation in a formation, but today, it's those younger players. Can they step up? It's a difficult game. It's an away game. Can they go there and put in a performance which will lead to me, for sure, giving them more chances? I don't need any invitation to see more of RIQUI PUIG & Co. And we are off. Lionel Messi here with a very early free kick into Umtiti. Back now to Messi. Puig is on the edge of the area here. Puig spinning, playing it back into the path of Messi. Denied there by the goalkeeper. But a good understanding already between those two. And it's Busquets here playing into the path of Puig. He's got a lot of space here. Advancing on goal, but the shot absolutely nowhere near. It is my personal mission to get Puig to score, but that's not going to be so easy given those shooting stats. Busquets again here, just laying the ball off to RIQUI Puig. Those two combining well in the early exchanges. Here's Lionel Messi now advancing again. Back heel into the path of Puig, who shoots for goal. Denied, but back out to Ansu Fati, who buries the rebound there from the right-hand side. Barcelona, inside 15 minutes, have the lead. And a second goal in two games for Ansu Fati. But so close there it was. RIQUI Puig and Lionel Messi combining brilliantly. Lovely little strike there. And Ansu Fati, do what you've got to do as an attacker. Always follow in. Always be alive. Barcelona with a nice early lead. Busquets again playing it into the path of RIQUI Puig here again. Just look at that. Look at the power. Look at the muscle there. He's able to hold off his defender. Very, very good play there by RIQUI Puig. Little pirouette turn by Sergio Busquets. And I've been really impressed with him too. I've got to say, I haven't played an awful lot of Busquets. I felt really bad about doing that. But here today, he's been absolutely brilliant. He just keeps things ticking over. He keeps the pressure on, wins the ball back. And certainly he, you can see, doing exactly that and lost the ball there by Griezmann. But good in the midfield today. Pedri now advancing into Getafe's half, but that does bring us to an end in that first half. It's Barcelona 1, Getafe 0, the goal scored once again by Ansu Fati. So far, so good for those youngsters. And to be honest, guys, as we kick off now into the second half, what I'm looking for is exactly the same, really, as what we saw in the first. A lot of confidence, a lot of good play. Puig, in particular, is starting to shine there alongside Busquets. Messi's linking up well, of course. Lovely little back heel there into the path of RIQUI Puig, who's looking now to find Griezmann. Messi's there in support. Lionel Messi goes for it, just deflected. And it's Griezmann into Puig. Now on towards Pedri, but we couldn't quite squeeze it in there. Might come back out, but it's declared there by Getafe. A real load of chances in there early on for Barca. Getafe coming forward now though with Jason, but a good challenge there by Todibo. And as you can see there, our next game, reminding me there, is going to be Inter. And for that reason, it's time for Lionel Messi to make for the bench. Lautaro coming on. We're going to rest him there. No chances taken. And I'm also going to rest Ansu Fati. Carlos Perez on. A little bit more rotation just to put some more young guys out there. And now it's Carlos Perez breaking from inside our own half. Again, looking up at RIQUI Puig advancing into that space. Great ball there. Lautaro Martinez has time. Lautaro Martinez does not fail from that position. RIQUI Puig with a brilliant assist. Lovely weighted pass. And Lautaro gobbles up that chance. Puts Barcelona 2-0 ahead. Moussawagé there winning the ball off very nicely from Cucurella. Here's Sergio Busquets. Puig again is advancing. RIQUI Puig into the area. RIQUI Puig has his goal. Absolutely incredible stuff. I am so happy that I was able to get him a goal today. He has been brilliant right throughout. He's always been looking for that space. He just carried it into the area. The defenders don't close him down. And a lovely little near post finish there for RIQUI Puig. Just takes it in his stride. Gets his goal. His first for Barcelona. And I am over the moon about that. Not sure if you noticed. But honestly, guys, that is an absolutely incredible moment right there. I think we all feel so much excitement there for RIQUI Puig, both in the game and also, of course, on real life when he does finally get his Barcelona chance. But let's see what more we can do here. Luis Lautaro. Now Carlos Alenia. He's the man moving into space. Could we get another one here? We have! Puig and Alenia scoring within minutes of each other. And Barcelona here, even without Lionel Messi, we are taking Getafe apart. Brilliant scenes here. The younger players coming to the fore, taking their chance. Alenia here was in on goal. He had so much time to think about it, but a lovely little finish there. Top right-hand corner. Oh, this is good fun. And genuinely, guys, I was not expecting this here. I was expecting a really, really difficult game. They've really impressed me, these players today. And who's next? Who wants the goal next? Maybe Carlos Perez could get on the score sheet. Maybe Pedri could get his first Barcelona goal. Here he is on the ball now. 10 minutes or so to go in this game. There's still much, much more we can get out of this. Puig with a little back heel into Carlos Alenia. Can we get more goals? Puig again advancing. Alenia, little 1-2s there. Brilliant foot from Barcelona. In by Pedri. RIQUI Puig. Oh, it's just gone wide. This is fantastic football. This is exactly what we want to be seeing. And Barcelona, we're not done yet. We are still going here. We want more goals. Here's Carlos Perez looking maybe there. Puig is making a good run. Perez twisting and turning into the path now of Sergio Busquets. Like I say, been so, so good today. RIQUI Puig turning, twisting. RIQUI Puig has got another one. Absolutely incredible. trouble here. RIQUI PUIG gets another goal. Two for him on the day. He had a first stab at it. The shot was blocked. Came back to him on the volley. He puts it into the bottom corner. And this is capping a wonderful display, not just because of the goals, but the overall performance here of this young man. And I am delighted. It's Barcelona 5, Getafe 0. The young guns, they destroyed them. And as we move into the closing moments of the game, we have to absolutely appreciate today this man on the ball now. And this is very, very good timing because they haven't been able to get the ball off him. RIQUI PUIG today has been irresistible against Getafe, and I'm down for that. It's been an absolutely brilliant game. So exciting. I've learned a lot about my players. And look, in the Champions League up next, yeah, we've rotated. But who knows? If we need a goal, if we need something, maybe for a head in the game, you will see these guys again because quite clearly, they have the quality that we need at Barcelona. And here is the post-match press conference. Please ask me a question about RIQUI PUIG. I dare you. Go on, do it. Come on, the media. Do your job. With two goals today, PUIG was the hero. Any thoughts? Well, you know what? I do have some thoughts. That guy is different gravy. Very, very impressive performance today from RIQUI PUIG. It was world-class. We're going to be seeing more of him, no doubt at all. Congratulations here. Your winning streak is extended. Can it go on? My players are very talented. I'm very, very fortunate to have them. And I'm so excited to continue the season and continue working with them. And it says here, Getafe is clearly not at your level by scoring 5 goals. Have you got any advice for Getafe? Well, it's not really my place to be giving out advice to Getafe. I'm the Barcelona coach. I'm not the Getafe coach, thank goodness. So I'm just going to say there, let's move on. Let's talk about Barca, because today we were outstanding. But that does bring us to an end in today's episode, guys. Another 2 wins for Barcelona, staying perfect so far under my managerial control. But up next, we've got a massive Champions League game against Inter. And as you can see there, from the early table, it's very, very important. Inter have won, Barcelona have won. We've got to go into that game, show what we're all about. We are going to be really, really looking to put out a statement. It's a big game at the Camp Nou. And I hope that every single one of you guys will join me for that. It'll be coming up soon. Thank you, as always, for your incredible support for the series. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And until next time, let's keep going. Visca el Barça.